Hey guys, welcome back to a new video. Today we are going to make an AI pin. Stick around till the end to see the final demo. Let's get started. For this step, we will need the CStudio JLCMC ESP32S3 board. Let's first set up the Arduino IDE. Go to the preferences menu, paste this link and click OK. Next, open the board manager, search for ESP32 and install it. Now, let's install the required library. Open the library manager, search for Universal Telegram Bot and install it. That's it. Our IDE is ready for coding and uploading. Now, let's make a Telegram bot. We will use Botfather to create a new bot. Just give it a name, set a username, and it will generate a token for you. Copy that token, we will need it in the code. Part 1. We will write a code that allows our Telegram bot to take a command from the user and reply with a simple preset message. In the code, I will add my Wi-Fi SSID, password, and the bot token we just copied. Then, I will select the JLCMC S3 board and port and upload the code. Today's video is proudly sponsored by JLCMC, one of the world's leading mechanical component suppliers. JLCMC is known for competitive pricing, top quality products, and lightning fast shipping. With over 6 lakhs plus SKUs, they have everything you need for your next project. Custom linear guide shafts, precision engineered for applications like 3D printing, CNC machines, and industrial automation. Aluminium profiles, versatile, durable framing solution, perfect for machine enclosure, workstation, and custom assemblies. Every month, JLCMC adds even more new products to their catalog. Head over to JLCMC today, place your order, and enjoy a $70 discount on your purchase. Don't miss out, visit JLCMC now and elevate your next build. Part 2. We will upgrade that same code so the bot can use an AI model to reply with intelligent responses. Now, let's make it smarter. First, I will head over to Google AI Studio and create a new Gemini API key. Once the key is generated, I will copy it and paste it into my code, replacing the placeholder. Now, our bot can connect to the Gemini API. Let's upload the updated code to the board and test it out. For this, we will connect the JLCMC S3 camera module. Before uploading the code, we need to enable PSRAM. To do this, go to the Tools menu, then under PSRAM selection, turn it on. Open the code and upload it to the board. Once the upload is completed, let's test it out. As you can see, when the bot receives the command, it captures an image, convert it into Base64, and reply with the first 50 characters as confirmation. Now it's time to combine everything. The new code merges step 1 and step 2. Here's how it works. When the user sends a command, the bot first asks for a query. Once the user sends it, the JLCMC S3 sense port captures an image, convert it into Base64. And along with the user query, sends it to the Gemini API. The API processes both inputs and generates a smart reply. With the code ready, let's now move to the hardware setup. To make our AI pin portable, we will need a few additional components, a 3.7 volt LiPo battery and a small switch. This will power the JLCMC S3 sense board. Now, let's wire everything up. I will solder the negative terminal of the battery directly to the JLCMC S3 sense port. Next, I will connect the positive terminal of the battery to the switch and then from the switch to the board. This way, we can easily turn the device on and off. Thank you. With everything assembled and the case ready, it's time for the final test. Let's power it on and check the AI pin in action.